Hey, folks, Quillatine here, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play EU4 Imperial Italy. We are at war. My plans going forward will involve mostly trying to declare war on people outside the HRE, take their provinces, add them to the HRE to get more Imperial authority, because it's still my hope to pass all these reforms. That's what I'm trying to play. That's the game I'm trying to play here. And it has occurred to me that being able to add these provinces to the HRE is a really good way to pump that up as much as possible. But we have to manage a few things. First of all, we have to manage coalition stuff. There is a relatively large coalition up against us, although quite a few of the places, like Austria over here, only has 17 aggressive expansion. Once that goes to zero, they have to leave the coalition. And if we can get them to like me a bit, then they might leave on their own. It's entirely possible. I actually have a bunch of free and idle diplomats right now, so I should probably just go and suck up to a few of these fellows and see if we might be able to... Well, that's actual Austria. Still, it might not hurt to suck up to Austria a wee bit. That's all Austria. Frankfurt over here. See, Frankfurt, we don't have to be like that. We are currently in a war. It's the Hungarian conquest of Nowy Sachs. We got called in by Hungary to come in and help out. And on the other side, it's mostly against Poland. We do have some troops over here because of... I don't know why. Why are we in this? It's been a few days since I played the last episode. I'm like, what are we doing? We're getting attritioned a whole bunch is what we're doing, actually. I don't know. Like, do we have any personal war score? Technically, a little bit. Are we hoping to get something out of this? I suppose we could. I mean, this is all our territory over here. We might be able to get one province from Poland as a separate piece if we can get 10% war score, which might be what we're trying to do. Let's see, we are sieging this fort out. I really should have watched my last video. How many cannons do we need here? Just 15. So we definitely have an excess. Can I do something like that? I can. There's a big Polish army over here, although me destroying the Polish army doesn't help things, because I will not get any war score for that. Now, I also don't get much in the way of war score for occupying provinces without forts. Mostly, it's just the ones with forts that do anything. Which, oh my god, that is a large stack of troops. What am I in? Farmland? Woods. I really would prefer not to be attacked anywhere, to be honest. How do we have so much... Oh! Russia's in on this? Russia's in on this. That is a very, very large number. What's my personal war score? 9%. You know what I'm tempted to do? Is this. Stand all my troops in Plock, or at least be ready. I'm going to stand here. I'll be ready to reinforce right away. Oh, I hope I didn't need to frack. That's really bad. That is really super ultra bad. I'm going to accept the loss there. I'll try to run as soon as I can, assuming we can without getting static wipe. Okay, we did. Now, one nice thing is, if we're not the war leader, we don't actually suffer... we're splitting on speed 4! That's what's partially happening here. And I was able to do the one step. Nice. Move into Pluck. So that you don't get your ass kicked too badly. Okay, and we're going to merge up. Still have a siege bonus, which is good. We'll do a consolidate out here, too. And yeah, I'm just going to keep as many people over here as possible. To discourage them from attacking me. And honestly, we might have been able to be offensive here. But again, why would I participate in an attack? Ah, we lost an advisor. I'll take the fort defense thing. That's fine. Oh, by the way, this is the first game being played on the actual 1.13 patch as opposed to the beta. It just came out today. A couple more changes have been made. Nothing too terribly severe. We'll see there. I haven't memorized the whole patch list, but I've got enough of a sense of it. I don't want to lose that province, because that would swing the war score in the opposite way. But I think we will make our own progress over here pretty well. And more troops are being picked apart over here. And I would very much like to be under this war. Out of this war. They cleared that, but that was not a fort province, so it is not relevant. Worst case scenario, it might add up to 1%, but it's going to be a fraction of 1%, generally speaking. As soon as we win this siege, we should be able to piece out. It will be a separate piece. But that's fine. I'm not too concerned about Hungary, actually. And honestly, we're more likely to get into conflict than anything else. Oh, I got some troops sitting around over here. Really? I don't know. I'll bring you home or something. Wow. That fort might fall really fast. Come on. Tick, 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 tick. I just want to peace out. Watch the AI get it at 7% and I won't get it at 49%. That would be all too typical. Damn it. Didn't get that tick. Defenders are deserting. How deserted are they? No, there's still way too many of them. Way too many. I'm getting so much attrition over here. 4.5%. I suppose I could split this in half and send some dudes over here and cut back the attrition. I'm just really worried about them pouncing on me. Like, and I think that might be what these guys are coming here for. So, again, I'll soak in a little bit more attrition to try to protect the siege. As soon as the siege goes, I should be able to peace out. Because they're willing to wipe peace because they're low, right? Yeah, they have low enthusiasm. Oh, hello. First of all, I thought I was paused. Secondly, let's absolutely do this. Do I want to reset my troops? It's only my cannons. Also, the admin? Well, we might have to core. So, although we'll have plenty of stuff left to core. Hello. Let's do that. I'll save the diplo points. Yeah, I'm not going to upgrade my unit type right now. Not unless these guys are moving away. That's so many troops in this area. Really? Another defender's desert? Really? Really? Failed at 49%, failed at 60%. Unbelievable. Now they're at 14%. Watch me not get the siege before they unsiege this. Crying out loud. They're still not moving or busy. I really would like to upgrade my cannons. But I'm not going to do it when it's going to reset so much of my morale. This is costing me so many men here. Just standing in this field. Alright, we're getting another tick. Although they're about to tick. Watch them win this siege. Oh, thank you very much for not screwing the AI. Come on, 77% chance. It's about to go. Boom. Excellent. Ooh, some truces ended. That's interesting. Alright, Poland. 12%, which means I can now ask for something. Apparently I have my pick. I mean, you can ask for, like, a variety of things. But the thing is, this is a fort province with 19 development. Yeah, you know what? I'll get it. It will add some aggressive expansion, obviously. But I'm not too concerned. Can I get, like... No, I can't get two. But I can get a few bucks. There we go. I don't think there's anything else I would want. Releasing nations, annulling treaties. No, because it's too much. I won't be able to get it. Because even with this, yeah, I'm just barely getting it. So I'll get a province and 500 bucks. A little bit more aggressive expansion. Which is always a little sketchy. But it's fine. Okay. Sure, you can have military access. We will go and upgrade our cannons to the mortars. I was going to say, there should be a little pop-up for the coring, which I will make core. That's what I wanted. I'm going to send everyone back to my actual land. I'm going to split them up so that they don't get overly attritioned walking through each other. So that's coring. And just let me double-check. I wonder if there'd be a different color. Like, it's... I'm not sure if there's a really good indicator. Yeah, see, like this. Like, when I go... For crying out loud, when I go to Imperial map mode, I want stripes on my own territory. Because here's the thing. If you go to diplomat mode, it will show you stripes anywhere where you have claims on other people's territory or they have claims on you. Like, or you're missing a core. There's all kinds of different things with the diplomat mode. I would like it if here, if it really highlighted provinces that, hey, you can add this to the HRE, or I would like a pop-up for it. Either way would be really, really, really appreciated. Because I can't add this until I can court. Alliance offer from Russia. Yes, please. Because I think we already had our royal marriage. This was just, you know, screwing up our relationship temporarily because we were at war. Okay, you're starting to move. There you go. Now, move down here. Then we'll reorganize. I think we'll need more infantry, especially since I did do a consolidate. In fact, I know we're well below our force limit, so let me go ahead and preemptively get some extra infantry up and running. Okay. Nice to have another fort. Ooh, Frankfurt left the coalition against us. I haven't been sucking up to them, so that's good. I can go ahead and spend some diplo points there. It's only cost me 270. Oh, lots of people are leaving the coalition. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Leaders is good. More offensive ideas. Well, We'll get it naturally whenever it comes up. We are not focused on anything. We have kind of a crap ruler and not a particularly good heir, although not a bad heir. Excellent. Still a few people in the coalition. And certainly we did generate a little bit more aggressive expansion over here, so they might want to stay in. But overall, the coalition is so weak as to not be a concern, which is a really nice thing to see. So yes, at some point, I'd like to take out Milan and Naples and add all their territory to the HRE. I didn't really get much credit for adding Napoli over here. Like, am I wrong? Does this not give imperial authority anymore? Maybe it doesn't? I mean, I know most things have been changed to the amount. Maybe I'm completely wrong about my plans and getting confused again. I thought me adding territory to the HRE would still give me imperial authority, but maybe they've gotten rid of that completely. I know they've gotten rid of most things. I thought that was still in there, but I clearly am remembering something incorrectly. And that's disappointing. Okay, I'm just going to let these guys come together and then do the group up and split so that we can get more balanced armies. And yeah, they're all going to be pretty cannon heavy. I mean, they're not fully reinforced, although speaking of which, yeah, they're basically there. I can do that. Armies are not 100% there, but mostly there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new template with like 5 infantry. And queue up 1 for each of those. There we go. I think that'll be a pretty well-balanced army. How's our navy count going? We are actually below our force limit, so let's go ahead and queue up a bit of that. You build ships very quickly, as do you. You do have some infantry queued up, but it's not the end of the world. And I'll queue up another one in Napoli, since you're so damn fast. So damn fast indeed. How is our culture status? We've got a little bit of Croatian, which is very unlikely to ever become accepted. The question is it too late in the game to justify culture conversions? Because here's the thing. By having the incorrect culture, we are losing some of our manpower, a third of our manpower, and we're also losing a third of our taxes. Do we also lose trade power? No, not trade power. So trade power doesn't matter. So do we want to spend 100 diplo points to counter the fact that we are getting not as much tax and manpower from these things? If it's very early in the game, then it's a great idea. If it's late in the game, that's a terrible idea. Where are we now? I don't know. I can say we're not ahead on diplo tech, so no, never mind. We're going to focus on the technology. It's a thing to do if you have an excess of diplo stuff, and we do not. Partially because we did take 2 separate diplomatic idea groups, which we have finished off. Mm-hmm. We should start to catch up at this point. Tech levels are really cheap right now. That last one was like 270 or something. It was ridiculous. This troop is, like, it's weird that this guy is so offset in the province. Why? And as soon as I merge them, they're fine. That's a weird graphical bug I've never seen before. They were, like, off-center. This is a unit in Romagna. Huh. I've never seen that before. Anyway, we are currently at peace. We do have some CBs against people. In particular, it'd be really nice to smack down France, especially since they're currently smacking around Provence, who does very good in this version of the game. If we declared now, Hungary would jump in on the French side. Milan would not. Cologne and Hesse, it's not quite enough. We really need Spain to be willing to join in. Spain's another war. Imperial liberation against Magdeburg, because they annexed someone. Bavaria left a coalition against us. More people. I mean, as soon as we take more territory, it's going to respawn, but at a certain point, we're going to be willing to accept permanent coalitions, but now I don't think it's the time. Oh, that's right. That's one of the reasons, actually, at some point we're going to be up against Hungary. Oh, no, we already took back this territory, which had been added to the HRE. Oh, no, they do have Moravia. So, yes, I will have to go up against Hungary, but they're allied to France, which is super awkward. They're already in a war together. Right, I was on, I think, the Hungarian side in the last one. That's going to have to go at some point. They're the only people. No, they're not. Who is this? The Netherlands, who are not in the HRE. Right. And we don't have a truce with them. Haiti and Brunswick. Brunswick's a little awkward, although Cologne and Hesse would join in on the other side. I think we're going on that war. I think we finished building all those little troops. Yeah, you know what? I don't think we're going to delay. Lack of manpower is a little low. And if we do respawn the coalition, it could be a little scary. No, we'll wait a little bit longer. No, they have, like, no allies. This is going to be a short war. It's not going to cost us anything. Again, with, like... Can't even tell what province you're in. This is new. I've never seen this before. I mean, I might be wrong. Maybe it's been in the a glitch in the game for a while. But I have never seen these units be, like, so incorrectly offset before. It feels like it's something new. Bum, bum, bum. Ships are being done. And yeah, let's charge this up and prepare for war. Should be relatively short. Unlawful territory. Yeah, I'm actually gonna, like, say that. Eh. Well, we'll demand it anyway. It'll ruin their relationships a bit. Okay. You suffered casualties. That is fine. Okay. Let's move up as far as we can and try to minimize attrition while we walk. And then there. Just going to wait until you move a tick. Boom, boom, boom. There you go. And then one more. And yeah, we'll go after the Netherlands. How's our trade coming along? 54% in Genoa. Provence is still, like, that would still be the ideal. Now, France is going to take a bunch of their stuff, which is actually really annoying. But taking that province would be the ideal. Okay, left the coalition. Coalition will respawn, and will be pretty heavy when it does. Because there's so many countries that were on the fringe of doing it. That being said, one of the things that did change is it used to be 30 was all it needed to join the coalition. Now it's 50. Although we actually have a lot of 50s, as is. Oh, it's going to be a little sketchy. We can declare war with people. Recall that diplomat. Got a little bit of attrition on the way, which is a bit annoying. It's partially because there's other people here. Okay. So, declare war. Brunswick. But Cologne and Hesse on our side. I think that's going to be fine. And we'll set the Limburg as the actual war goal. It's a fort. We're going to have to take this before we get to the rest anyway. And we're going to have to take this to flip things in the end, so. Okay. Declare war. Now, some of those others might join late. That's always possible. We can do that. Now, you don't have siege. Where's our siege guy? You can reach Loon. Good. You don't have siege either. You're the one with siege. That's in the furthest back. Okay. But we can go and stand in all their stuff right away. Also, we should probably do the same thing with Brunswick. Who is not Catholic? Hello! We're actually going to start with you. And force you to convert over. That's going to be really helpful. Now, hardly any people in here. Oh, there's some territory over there in Friesland. No, I don't need to call in anyone else. Actually. I guess I didn't have them checked off. I think we're going to be fine. You know what? I will save my allies for a future call. That's okay. Da, 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 da. Where'd my army go? Oh, there it is. Yeah, we're just going to have it stand in Brunswick. Which belongs to, yeah, Brunswick. And we want Brunswick to convert their religion over. Actually, hang on. I'm going to take this whole stack, move it up there. You, split, go there, split again, go there. We'll get a full siege on the Netherlands. Shut down all their income. So while taking a province that doesn't have a fort doesn't give you much in the way of war score, it still shuts down their income and crushes their force limit and does all kinds of horrible things to them. This is going to be a pretty easy war. Oh, were you in another war? Yeah, you were too. Like, why are you sieging that stuff? Mecklenburg! I got you, buddy. Actually, apparently you've got yourself. Good for you. Well, I'm just going to let this guy roam around. Do we have enough cannons here for the full bonus? No. We need 15, and we have 12. That's kind of annoying. You've got some extra cannons, though. Why don't you go and stand over here? Actually, I'll get you to go in there, and then we'll split off some non-cannons. Recall some diplomats. There we go. Occupy all those things. What about over here? Oh, we also don't have the full cannon bonus. We need 3 more in there. You. Go there. Excellent. And then you guys just group up over here so we can guard our main troops. Okay. Things are changing. All fine. And what I can do is pull some of the infantry out. Just to cut back on our attrition. Good. And that's going to flip in a second. Milan, take Trent. Alright, you go over there, and you cut the infantry down to size, cut back on attrition, just sit back and wait. I think we're in pretty good shape here. Fully defensive, oof, and a mild winter, oof, that hurts. Alright, you're fallen, good, let's go and just stand over here. Merge you up. There we go. Yeah, we'll convert another heretic over. Now, most of our ticking is being taken away by the heretics right now. Also, 7 provinces, non-member. It'd be nice if we could just force the Netherlands to be part of the HRE. Unfortunately, one of the things is I think they're probably too big to vassalize. Ooh, no, they're not. Hello, that's what we're doing. That's really going to lead to a fair amount of aggressive expansion. But it's going to be a huge win. Because A, I think that won't bring them into the HRE, but I think that the provinces will be considered part of the HRE for eliminating that. I hope. Plus, it gives us a port on the northern side, which is really nice. And it's the Netherlands itself, where we don't. If we took the provinces away from the Netherlands, we might get those stupid events where they want to defect to the Netherlands because of things. Okay, England being a jerk. What's our... We're at 9 of 6, which is quite a bit of a relationship, but it's still going to be worth doing. Do we have... Mecklenburg is a vassal at 200%, which is good. Oh, if I eat you up, though, that means we ate up a member of the HRE, which will upset a lot of people. Speaking of upsetting people, the aggressive expansion, one of the things we do have to worry about, is not being re-elected. So that's less than good. My king is pretty young right now, although he is leading some battles. He's 40. He's getting on a little bit. Here. On demand. Cologne declared war in the Netherlands. That's interesting. Because I'm pretty sure what this means is... When I peace out, when I vassalize the Netherlands, I'll be brought into a war against Cologne. They don't have any actual allies other than me, though. And we could force Cologne to release a bunch of nations, which doesn't generate aggressive expansion, so that's good. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going to vassalize the Netherlands. I'm hoping this doesn't ruin my reputation too much. But we got to start making some aggro mobs at some point. And basically anyone out of the HRE is going to be fair game. Okay, let's go up a notch in speed. Just waiting for the sieges to do. Austria left the coalition. Nice. They'll re-enter. Once we when we vassalize the Netherlands, holy crap are people going to jump in. It's going to be sick. Sick, sick, sick. 666, the disease of the beast. Pure liberation against the Platinet. I mean, at least there's, you know, some internal kerfuffleage going on. Although it'd be nice if there was literally zero internal kerfuffleage, because then we would get a massive bonus to our authority. Oh man, we actually lost a point because I think another prince got eaten up. Yeah, we're down to 34. We need to get 35 for another percentage. Okay, you! Separate piece out. No, I don't want to vassalize you. I'm going to get enough aggressive expansion as is. Negotiating for yourself. You will convert to Catholic. You'll give me some prestige. You'll also give me war reparations, all your money, and break off your relationship with Bohemia. Boom. Okay. Which will get rid of Heretic Prince, just hasn't protested yet. I'm going to have to move these guys into friendly territory for the war declaration against Cologne. Otherwise, I'll be black flagged over here. And I think my vassal should count. Actually, what I can do is move in here. This is the woods, but we should be able to attack without a crossing penalty. I don't know about over here. This guy might get black flagged. Anyway, you move up there, you move that way. Okay. How come we don't have... Oh. Because you're overseas bullshit. Right. We don't have 100% war score. That's kind of frustrating. So we're going to have to wait a long time. We're going to have to wait for the 5 years of the war to have gone through before they're going to be willing to peace out. It's a little bit annoying. On the other hand, I mean, I guess we'll just lower some aggressive expansion while we wait. I suppose that's fine. But yeah, there's no reason I would want to go overseas. So where are you? All down here. Gotta say, oh! And this actually belongs to you and actually has a fort. No, that's really bad. Oh no. I won't get 100%. I do have to go over there. Because I can't get 100% war score unless I actually occupy all their land. I have to build a big bunch of transports and hope I can get them over there. Which is going to be tricky. So Haiti doesn't matter. Huh. You have fleet basing rights out of Spain. Which I guess would help. Anyway, let's start with this. Although that might be a little bit premature. And we are going to build 10 transports. What? Oh, yeah, it's letting me know about the force limit thing. That's fine. Now, I do have some transports already, but not a whole lot. Move them in over there. You can work Genoa. And Genoa. Oh, I didn't realize I have a bunch of ships that are literally just standing around from a previous war. Oops. You get thrown into Genoa. And then... Actually, I think... Actually, the last batch can work the Seville trade node. I think that'll be good. Okay, we got our fleet basing rights. Sure. Meanwhile, I suppose all my troops can come home and be ready to do transport stuff. France declares war on Burgundy. Woo! That's interesting. And we've got some cores. That's in Poznan. Now, can I add you? I can. Increase imperial authority. I have 7. Yeah, it gave me 1. Maybe it's just 1 per province. Maybe that's what I'm misremembering, is the amount that you get. Oh yeah, I moved them in a bulk like this, so there's going to be some attrition. I gotta be a little careful about rebels over there. Lost a claim against Mecklenburg. I'm okay with that, actually. Mecklenburg over here, my vassal. People can attach to this. Actually, let's go ahead and upgrade that one ship. Oh, yeah, no, it happens instantly. That's right. And then it gets repaired. That's very good. And yeah, I'll accept going over my force limit. This would be a nice thing to have, like, Crusader King style mercs for ships. Would actually be very handy. So we're going to have 12. I'll gain the prestige. I'm not short on prestige, but what the hell. Move you to Rome. And create a new group over here. We're going to have 12 dudes that we can move with us. So I think what I would like to do is have 5 cannons. Because I'm going to hope there's not much in the way of forts, in which case 5 will give us our maximum siege. And then 2 of you. And then that would leave 5 there, which does give us a bigger front line than the cannons, which is something. Hopefully, I don't expect there to be a massive, massive defense. So I think we're going to be okay. And I'm going to bring this one here with the siege bonus. Truce of Bohemia ended. All right. Transport ships are coming in. Can invest in a new offensive idea, which I guess we'll do. Recruitment time decrease isn't a huge deal. But it still helps. Galliot, is that a transport? No, it's not. Never mind. Navy morale might help for what's going to come up. Okay. More ships. Oh, royal marriage with Russia just ended. And I just realized this is not building up properly. There's some double queues of things. See, you build fast. Skip another one. And queue up another one here. Cancel you and you. Okay. I don't need to call anyone in. Oh, Russia. Let's get re-royal married. Lovely. France, we're still the same. Yep, we're still the same dynasty. Nothing's ever come of it, but it's technically there. Mm-hmm. Okay, you're back. I should suck up some of these princes again. Yeah, it's nice just to have votes and things, too. I mean, for my my policies. That's me. Grind, grind, grind. Oh, I don't have a dude left. Okay. That's fine. Wow. Randomly lose 15,000 manpower. Damn. That's brutal. Okay, I'm spending money on my docking stuff. If I were to randomly grab a fleet. Yeah, supplies, not bad. We'll be able to get there pretty safely. Okay. Truce Cilicia ended. Annex subjects went away. That's really good. Because that was massively impacting our Diplo rep, which has a huge impact on what people want to vote for. Hey, there's peace in the Empire, right? Right now, I'm not technically at war with anyone in the Empire. That is really good for our authority development. Okay, we're up to 10 transports. That's not bad. Where are the last 2 coming in? Pretty close. These are 2 fast ones. So we'll get a dozen guys. Let me pull in, say my... Here's a question. The Netherlands. How big is your navy? I think it's just... Is it just Netherlands? Netherlands. Oh, you've got nothing. Good. So we can take, say, this smaller stack here. Just out of curiosity, how much was I pulling in? Quite a bit. Okay, but yeah, this stack of 38 lights... We're going to get you to join in my transport. You're going to be the escorts. Finishing the last of the repairs on those upgrades. Last 2 ships just spawned as well. You guys can join in over here. Now, we don't have an admiral. I don't think we need one. Although, if I did, yes, and got good maneuver, that brings down some of the attrition, which is nice. Yeah, we have 1 too many leaders, but that's okay. Although... I suppose I could fire this one. He's not bad, though. But I don't normally need the Admiral. So I think I'll just get rid of the Admiral after this. Okay. Merge up. You get on the fleet. And the fleet is going to come to here. If need be, we can actually dock in the Spanish territory. Although, the Spain itself actually have provinces, or just Spanish Brazil. And I don't think we actually get docking rights there. I think mostly we're just docking from over here, or maybe a little spit of something over here. It doesn't look like it, though. So, we don't actually have to take care of, like, Haiti, for example. Because while we can't get 100% war score right now without taking out all of Haiti, after 5 years, all we need is the Netherlands. What's this? Oh, I have another transport that wasn't actually being used. Whoops. All right, well, park yourself there. Take a look at my fleet. Make sure they're okay. Taking a little bit of damage, but not too much. And some of that was actually mostly the at-sea stuff, which is good. We are outside of our supply, but minus 3% leader maneuver. Nice. Makes a difference. Time at sea, I think, might go up. I'm not sure if this counts, though, because we're not in the middle of nowhere. I guess, okay. So, this looks like I'm going through this territory, but I'm not. It's important that I don't land on top of them. And, in fact, I'm going to land in the mountains. They should really move there to be in the mountains and deny myself a landing. Because now they're not going to be able to move me out of there. It's going to be fantastic. Oh, shit, they have a bigger fleet than I expected. I guess I didn't check out the Haiti numbers. Nine heavies. Oh, they're mostly transports, though. I can't read this. I mean, we're losing more morale. Yeah, and actually, they're just losing transports. Now, are you still moving? No, you're not. Because of the battle. And in fact, we're going to lose some transports. Okay. Pull back. Get over there. Actually, does one of these have a repair building? Because there is a repair building for navies, isn't there? Force limit. There you go. Shipyards. Grand shipyards. So shipyards have got the little bones on them. I think we might have a shipyard in Venice, actually. And we do. So that's where our ships should retreat to, and our new ones should meet up. Although we can't reinforce from there. Never mind. Just hang out in Siena. And we'll send some extra dudes in there, and we'll figure out a new composition. Grr! Can I? Nope. Can't dock. Still, that was a fluke. There must have been one that was really, really, really heavily damaged. So it's the Haitian Navy is huge. So I underestimated the size of the Haitian Navy. Or I really just never considered that it might be a threat. I don't suppose we'd have time to build like one galleon. 300 days. Maybe. Could happen. And let's go ahead and get an extra couple of transports here. Wherever they build quickly. Well, that was annoying. That belongs to Spain, which shortens some of our distance a lot. That was really annoying. I just assumed Haiti would be a non-issue. Oh my god, I didn't realize this has been a 38-minute long episode, so we're going to have to put a cut in here. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time, folks. Bye-bye.